deliberate about it, or do we just want it to be something that happens to us? And I believe that we shouldn't allow what people think of us to just happen to us. We have to deliberately decide, authentically, as it says, because you really said this thing well, what do we want people to think of us? And my view is that we should have a personal brand. And in the context of what we're discussing today as rebranding Ghana and driving business growth, the truth of the matter is that ultimately, regardless of the tagline that we choose from that brand Ghana, Ghana is going to be branded by its people. Right? Somebody may meet me as the only Ghanaian they will ever meet in their lifetime. And what they think of me is going to set their view of Ghana, brand Ghana, forever. Everything else will add to that or take away from it. If I'm the first one they meet, it sets the tone. Equally, we talk so much here about Ghanaians are so corrupt, Ghanaians are different. I was actually pained recently, I was in another country, I had a business discussion, and the subject of integrity comes up. And my response is, isn't it so sad that as business leaders, when we talk about my country, we have to ask about integrity? It has to be a given. It shouldn't even be a topic that we discuss. It should have been part of our brand that people say, people of Ghana, the people of Ghana have integrity, so we don't need to discuss that. So we do need to be deliberate about our branding to each other, to start with, to the world, but it's about the individual, and that's why personal branding matters so much.